again into an anisotropic direction. Children, in previous class we come from the wildlife, right, of tundra region. So in this session we are going to start with the life of the people. I said a little bit about life of the people in previous session. There are very less amount of people over there. Somewhere the population is less than 60,000. Somewhere around 60,000. Okay, population is around 60,000. And there are dwarfs over there. Small dwarf people over there. People live only in coastal region. Why in coastal region? Because of fishing. Okay, why in coastal region is because of the fishing part. They live in the coastal regions. People who live here are known as Inuits. People living here are known as Inuits. People who live in the tundra region are known as Inuits. Okay, they prefer this name because which means real man. Inuit means real man, the name of Eskimo. People who live here are Inuits. They prefer this name, which means real name, to the name Eskimo. Eskimo means eater of a raw meat. Inuits means real man. Eskimo means eater of raw meat. They eat raw meat also. These raw meat, no children, it will help them to fight against the cold. Eater of raw meat. This raw meat, no, it will help them to fight against the cold. Okay, it's very cold, right? So this will help them. Inuits live in the snow houses called igloos. Like how we have pakka houses, no? Even they live in the igloos. Where they live? They live in the igloos. Igloos means what, children? Their house is made like somewhat like this. Completely like ice type. Okay? It's like an ice type. This is completely a blocks of ice. Okay? And to prevent them from cold, in the inside, you know, it will make them to warm in winter season. In summer season, they will make hut type. Okay, with the help of animal fur, they will make hut type in summer season. In winter season, igloos are the which should keep them warm, which will prevent them from extreme cold. As I said, winters are very harsh and very cold. Okay, they use this blocks of ice and they will make it as an igloos. And in summer, with the help of animal skin, they will make this tent. And the Inuits are hard working and cheerful people. Children, they live in peaceful and harmony. They will make their own roots to help the animals, and they are very hard working and they will share among themselves the food and they will have it. It's not like they will fight for that alone. They are expert hunters and fishermen. We can't say farmers because there is less. No, it's a rare farming. Fishing, farming is over rare over there because not amount of soil also, not amount of the sun river. So people are hunters and fishermen were over there. Okay, they used to kill with the different types of we can say different types of metals they used to kill. They will have spears, they have knives and all, they have harpoons. Harpoons is a long spear with a leather rope attached. Like a long spear, okay, leather rope attached. They attach a leather rope. Okay, this is used for catching fishes, like big whales and all, they will use it. Okay, they have many tools to kill the animals, to hunt the animals, and they will kill them and they will have the food. And harpoon is one among them, so it's to catch the fishes, whales, fishes and all. Okay, now harpoons is, now harpoons, before they used to have harpoons, now it has been replaced by the rifles, guns. Okay. Then, if the travel purpose, what they will do, it's a, because it's a completely ocean, sea part, right, completely near the ocean, so what, they will make a small boats, which is known as kayaks, okay, small boats are known as kayaks, to hunt sea animals, they will use small boats, a kayak, and they have to travel from one place to another, they will have a umayaks, okay, and umayaks, for small fishes and sea animals, they will hunt with the small boats called kayak. Okay, kayak for small sea animals, small animals. And for big bait, it is a umayak. It will be very big. It is a umayak for whales and all. These umayaks are used for traveling for passengers also. Passengers and boats also, they will use this umayaks. Okay. Now, transport is available for people to move over here and there, to travel here over there. But before, they used to travel in, if one or two person, they used to travel in kayaks, and for hunting also, small sea animals, with the help of kayak. They used to hunt. They used to go in the kayak and they used to hunt the animals. But if they are hunting large animals like whales, sharks and all, with the help of mayak, they used to hunt it. Okay. Now, because of the communication, a very good communication because of the modern methods and all, now they are able to communicate and travel properly with the help of cars, jeeps and airport. Airways is also available over there. Now, modern land transport is also available there. Okay, children. Now, changing lifestyles of Inuits. How many? For hundreds of years, they were living with the fishing only, by killing and hunting, fishing, gathering wood during the summer and spring rivers, like they used to stay. But now, as it has undergone many changes from last few years, people have started to settle over there. They used to live in this way, right? Like in the huts and igloos. Now, buildings are there over there. Some of the buildings are during winters also. Anyway, apart from this, also old children. As see, time changes for everything, right? They used to stay like this, but because of the communication, because of the modern technology, people started to live like a Meccan, like a cities, towns, they started to live over there. Now they have modern facilities with schools, hospitals, electricity, shops. Now they have everything over there because of the modern communication, right? And technologies, okay? Now people used to use tools, okay? Man-made tools, they used to use it, but now they start with hunting with the rifles, and now motorboats are available for fishing. Instead of the kayaks and kayaks, motorboats are available for fishing. Nuuk has become a modern city. Nuuk was the city, right? Now Nuuk has become the modern city, which is the center for fish processing. Fish processing, they'll take the fish and they'll process the fish with the help in the city of Nuuk. Fish has been exported in many countries. Okay, fish are exported in many countries means they send the fishes to other countries. Some towns of Greenland have been connected to the Denmark and North America through air services. So air services means airports. Okay, with the help of airports, you can fly. It has been connected with the Denmark and the North America. Greenland is also developing very fast because of the science and technology. Yes, Greenland is also developing. Earlier, people used to stay like they don't know about other world. People doesn't know apart from this Denmark, apart from this our Greenland is some other world. No, people never knew. No, we knew. Even we knew, even they knew. Apart from this region, we have equatorial region also, we have Arctic region also, other than. Many industries such as mining and oil drilling have been established. So many industries have been established like mining and oil drilling. Okay children, many industries have been developed like mining and drilling, oil drilling machines also, industries also, they have been established over there. Children, this is a very short and sweet chapter. It suggests related about the vegetation, climate and about the people living over there and about the modern. Okay, I'll just do a recap of everything, okay? In a small way.
Winters are short and winters are long and very
In midnight also you can see the sun is shining. So it has got the name Land of Midnight Sun. Okay, Land of Midnight Sun. Then if we come from vegetation, this we have completed about climate for children. Summers are short, winter is the long and cold. And it is also known as Land of Midnight Sun. Okay, Land of Midnight Sun. Okay, and children, about this Land of Midnight Sun, it is about the location. Then if you come for the this kind of, there is a long, big ice masses, right? There is a big ice masses called iceberg, which down under the sea it is very big, but above the sea you can see very small, but it is deadly dangerous. If sailors are traveling over there, they should be very careful when traveling. Okay, if they go and hit this ice mass, it's very difficult to survive over there. Okay. Then they are not, because sometimes with traveling also, sometimes in normally also, because of the smoke, because of the high snows and all, it is completely invisible. During morning time and all, in winter season, during morning, it is completely invisible outside. Whatever it is going also, it is invisible. So much smoke will be over there. Then if you come for the vegetation, it is very space, no nil amount of vegetation over there. Because there are no black soil, there is no red soil, there is no sunrise, there is a nil amount of vegetation over there. We cannot grow crops over there. Okay, so people prefer to eat raw meat or meat. They'll kill that, they'll hunt the animal and they will eat. Okay. And if you come for wildlife, how animals are surviving over there? Because their skin is a completely thick and fur. The skin which they have on their body is completely thick and is completely fully covered with fur, okay. And the climate can survive in Greenland. With the help of the skin only, they can survive in the Greenland. The common word, what are the animals which are there over there? Huskies, Arctic fox, musk ox, wolf and reindeer, polar bears are the animals over there. And if you come for water park, we have whales, we have seals, walrus, okay. And this, and during the summer season, different birds will start to migrate over there, okay. And they'll find their food also. They'll come in purpose of food also, and they'll start to migrate over there. Different types of birds from different countries also. Then, if you come for life of the people, people living over there is less than around 60,000 or less than 60,000 people. Okay, there are interiors are inhabited. They are not interior regions are not inhabited. People live in the coastal region only. Why coastal region? Because for the fishing purpose. Okay. And people who are living there are known as Inuits. Okay, the Inuits means real man, and Eskimos means eater of the raw meat. They are known as Eskimos and Inuits. Okay, and they live in the houses. In winter, they live in the houses called igloos, and in summer season, they will make the huts with the help of animal skins. Okay, and in winter season, the big blocks of ice will make it as igloos, right, which will prevent them from the harsh and cold. The ice block will prevent from the harsh and cold. In summer, the animals fur, with the help of animal furs, they will prepare the tent and they will stay over there. Okay. And the tents are called as taupigs. It's the last time I forgot. It is known as taupigs. Like how we have ice for prepare the houses with the help of ice igloos, tents are called as taupigs. Okay. Inuits are hardworking people. If they want to hunt, they will go in group and they will hunt and then themselves and they will have, and they are just like a dwarf, small height, very small over them. Okay, and with that meat, whatever they are killing and the hunting they are made, you know, which will help them to prevent from the harsh cold. And they'll kill the animal, they'll take that skin and they'll prepare their clothes also. The skin of the animals are helpful for them to the prevent of cold. Okay, and they use many tools to kill the animals. One such tool is harpoon, knives, there maybe weapons. Okay, one such tool is harpoon, which is like a spear. Okay, and they use with that leather thread. Okay, it is used for killing the big whales and all. Okay, you have seen how blue whale is the largest animal, right, in the water world. Okay, it will help, it will kill, they will use to kill them. Okay, now to hunt small animals in the ocean and water bodies, what they will do? They use a kayak, which is small, like fishes, little animals, they will take this kayak. But if they want to hunt big animals, they will use umayaks. Umayaks are used for transport from the people and passengers and goods also. Okay. And some of the ice places also, if they make a off and then huskies and mount bulls and all, they start to pull over there. Okay, then changing of the lifestyles of Indians, people were living very not traditional life over there because they didn't have any communication in the from the modern world. Okay, no communication, no technology, but now people have enough amount of technology and they, and import and export is also being done over there. Okay, now schools and hospitals are open there, shops are open there, and it has been an attractive tourist places also to be in over there. And that many changes have also been done in the near the in the Greenland. First people used to eat only animals, they'll kill and eat the animals. But now because of the import and export, even vegetation, like normal vegetable food also is available over there. Okay? Like the new many towns and small cities also built over there. And new keys and modern became has modern city which is for fish processing. Okay? The fishes are being taken down and then process the fish, import and export the fish from them. Okay. And many Greenland is being connected to the Denmark and North America also with the help of air services. Means airports are built to connect it over there. And industries are also been industries like fishing and mining is also been mining and drilling, oil drilling is established over there. Okay, children, this much I have. Hope you have got understand. Please everyone take out your textbook. Soon we will finish off this TB exercises. Okay. Page 233, children, take the correct option. Exercise A. Polar regions are also known as dash zone. Frigid zone. Polar region is also known as frigid zone.
Okay, if any doubts are there, we'll meet in our interactive session. Bye bye, children. Take care.